Hi there, Natalie with you today with a new process video for Altenew. And today I want to show you a layout that works in different levels with mixed media and also adding a very colorful palette. For this I'm going to use actually the embossing powder, the Build a Flower Hellebore stamp set and die, and a few very colorful inks. So let me show you what I created for this layout. I decided that I wanted to use a very colorful palette because the picture that I'm going to document is of my niece when she first got her braces. So she's wearing this really bright pink sweater, so I wanted something that was going to be very contrasting on the page. So you're going to see that I'm going to start by kind of having an idea. I want to create sort of a C shape with the flowers, and the first thing I want to do is I want to kind of matte the background. And to what I mean by matte the background is I want to create a very neutral contrast on the background. And for that, to contrast white, I'm going to actually bring some black color. And for this, I'm going to use the watercolor brush refills. I'm going to use jet black. And all I'm going to do literally is add droplets onto my page. And I'm using double heavy cardstock. This is 140 pounds. It's actually from Vicky Button. And what I'm doing is just sprinkling some of the water. You're going to see that I added a piece of plastic on the side where I have added just a drop of my liquid watercolor and added a little bit of water just to dilute it a bit. And all I'm doing is splattering the mixture, in this case with the pigment, on top of the splatters of water, and then just helping to move it around with my brush. I'm a fan of creating this type of backgrounds just because I know that it's gonna be literally, it's gonna be underneath the flowers, and all it's gonna do is kind of take the light away and create the contrast that I'm looking for. So you're gonna see that all I'm doing, like, I remember I said I want to create sort of a C shape behind my picture and the flowers. And for this, I am gonna go ahead and add the in this case the watercolor or diluted watercolor, kind of creating that kidney shape that I'm looking for. And you're gonna see that I work a lot with splatters. I mean, try to be careful not to have the splatters all over the page. I want to keep it right around, like I said, that kidney kind of C shape that I'm looking for. So all I'm doing again is adding the splatters of water, adding the pigment, in this case the jet black watercolor, liquid watercolor that I've diluted a little bit with water, and then just kind of helping move it around with my brush just to create the C. Now, I did not add gesso to the background because I don't want the paint to stretch or move. I want to kind of mark the place where it's gonna go. And because I'm not adding also lots of water, you're gonna see that it's very little water that I'm adding. That's why the pigment is pretty much staying in place once it hits. Now, the advantage of working with this type of cardstock, this, like I said again, this from Vicky Button, is that it has a small like a soft coating on it, so allows the water to stay afloat a little bit, which is allowing me to kind of move it around with my brush. But because, like I said again, you're gonna see that I don't add lots of water, it actually is ideal for this. Now, if you want to add your mixed media and kind of help it move the watercolor, kind of create your own background, moving the colors, mixing them, then I will suggest you add yes. So, but for this one, just because I want to create that imprint of the dark color on the cardstock, I'm just gonna use it as is. It is gonna be create a tiny little bit of warping, not lots. The key for that is I'm gonna set it aside to dry completely on its own. I'm not gonna hit it with my gun or anything. I just wanna make sure that it dries completely on its own before I continue on. Now, this is the second part. You're gonna see that I'm gonna bring, actually, this is the square weave stencil set. Stencil, and I'm bringing the embossing paste. And all I want to do is create a little bit, bring a little bit of that white to the background. A lot of this is going to be hidden, but there's little corners that are going to pop through the flowers. And the only idea that I'm bringing is to break some of the black from the background, to bring some texture. And I just, if you look at my niece's sweater, it's very, what we called in the house, very streetwear. That's what she called it. So this just gave me the idea of streetwear. So I'm just gonna add a very thin application of the texture paste, the embossing paste, and I'm gonna set it aside to dry completely again. Until then, I'm gonna work on the flowers. And the flowers that I wanna use for this are the Hellebore, the Build a Flower Hellebore set. And I use quite a few inks that are gonna make it really, really colorful. So the ink sets that I'm using for this, for the leaves, I'm using Green Fields. For the flowers, flowers, I'm using a pocket full of sunshine. I'm using the mini ink cube sets. I'm gonna use rose petal and red sunset, and I'm gonna bring a little bit of orange cream, paper bag, and sun kiss just to create the centers of the flowers. And you're gonna see that I'm using my stamping platform just to create all the flowers to help me speed up the process. But I'm actually gonna link onto the blog post just the layering guide, so you can see step by step how to create these flowers. Very easy flowers to create, beautiful flowers. There's a lot of movement in the design of the flower, that's why I chose them. So you're gonna see that I'm gonna create the three different the three different sets of the flowers. So there's a full bloom, a little bit of a side kind of medium bloom flower, and then a bud. So I'm creating all of them, and the same thing with the leaves. So you're gonna see that I stamped in all the colors that I use. The one is a little bit on the reddish, one is very purplish, kind of violet, and the other one is this really bright yellow. And those are the colors that you see in the background. In my niece's jacket, it's all the colors that I saw. So you're gonna see that I'm gonna just show you a little bit, and I'm gonna take it off camera and continue working on it, and actually stamped all the leaves and I cut everything. Now that I have everything set, all I did to the picture is back it with a piece of paper from the Live Your Dream collection, and also from the Alluring blooms, just small frames, just something that's gonna make it stand out from the all the flowers. And once I have that, I'm gonna create the cluster of flowers. I'm gonna show you one, because the other one's gonna be pretty much the same thing. So what I always start when I create my cluster of flower is with a main image, and I want that pinkish. This is the one that I created with the rose petal ink set, and it's kind of on the little bit on the fuchsia, very muted kind of purplish tone. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create, that's gonna be the focus of this cluster. But you're gonna see that I'm gonna bring some of that reddish kind of corally tone and the yellow. And my way is, because I want that purple to be the image that stands out, I'm gonna kind of prop it with some foam adhesive. That's just gonna make it more prominent. It's gonna create some dimension, it's gonna create some movement. And then the rest of the flowers I'm gonna tuck in behind these flowers, so it's gonna look like they're coming from behind. They're gonna help create the cluster, they're gonna bulk up this cluster. Now, one of the things that this stamp set, which I'm using the Hellebore, the Build a Flower Hellebore, is that it has little stems where like the little buds are kind of coming off the flower. Now, when I'm gonna use, I wanted to use evergreen, I think, to stamp the little stem. It did not show on the black background, so my choice was I went and pulled the moss artist marker from Altenew. This is from set D, I believe, and I just kind of hand drew the little stem by just flicking the brush part of the marker, and then I'm just gonna add some foam adhesive to attach the buds at the end of the impression that I created with the marker. After that, all I'm gonna do is just add some leaves in between the flowers. You're gonna see that I add some foam adhesive behind some of them. Some of them are just glued straight onto the paper. That's just gonna, like I said before, it creates help movement, helps create dimension, and that helps just to break up the 2D monotony look of this page and give it a little bit of motion and action. Once I have that, you're gonna see that, like I said, I'm gonna create the big cluster at the top left corner of the picture. I'm gonna take it off camera and kind of create the same idea of a cluster at the bottom of the picture. And you're gonna see that I'm creating like a sweeping motion, like I said, like kind of a kidney area, kind of a C. I'm not gonna completely fill the entire C. I'm gonna leave that tiny little space in between, just so I can show the little bit of the texture that the background has, and also because I don't want it to be so heavy. Once I have that in place, you're gonna see that I'm just adding small buds, just kind of help me with the movement of the flowers. And then to create the title of the page, it's pretty much done. I'm gonna use the fancy hello die to cut two die cuts, in this case of the word hello, out of metallic craft paper. And I'm gonna glue them together so that creates a little bit of a dimension, not lots. And then I'm gonna glue it straight to the side, to the, in this case, the right of the picture. And after that, I'm gonna use the word new smile. I'm gonna spell it with some of the alphas that I have in my stash. They kind of match the colors of the jacket. And like I said before, the picture of my niece, the first day that she got her braces, she came over to visit and I took a picture. It was a brand new sweater. It was a brand new set of braces. So it was a reason to celebrate. And she was so happy, even though she was in pain, just because she was wearing that really colorful sweater. So you're going to see that I'm going to put, like I said, my title is going to be Hello New Smile. And after that, I'm going to bring the Across the Pond stamp set and actually some obsidian black ink from Altenew to stamp the word "You are marvelous," because I thought it just made it, she just shined that day, even like I said, even though she was in pain. After that, you're gonna see that I'm gonna add just a few stickers from my stash, but I'm gonna bring the enamel dots, the yellow dot, I think it's called a Pocketful of Sunshine, and just add a few hearts just where I added those stickers, just to bring some of the yellow. After that, I'm gonna add my Lancet journal right underneath the title, and that's about it. I love how this turned out. It did take some time to put together, I'm not gonna lie, just because it took a while to dry the background and to create the flowers, but well worth it. It's so beautiful. I love the color, I love the movement, and I think you should try it. It's a great way to combine, like I said, a contrasting colors with some mixed media and some dimension in one page. As always, if you have any questions, do not hesitate to contact me. I am gonna link the blog at the bottom description so you can see it, but also don't forget to subscribe to the channel. There's a lot of content coming in and I think you're gonna enjoy it. Thank you so much for joining me today. Take care, guys.